Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject, embedded system was embedded software compilation. So just like a general purpose computers, the embedded system softwares is also having the compilation process. So we all know that compilation is nothing but it's a conversion of one language to another language. So the high level language is going to be converted into assembly language and then to machine level language. So this machine language can be understood by the processor. So this is the high level language, which is like English like sentence. So the user can understand the high level language and the machine can understand the machine level language. So to convert all these steps into the machine level language, like in the form of ones and zeros, this compilation will be useful. So the compilation is a software which is used to convert one language to the another language. Okay, so let me show you that thing. So HCLL, this is a high level language. So the high level language is going to be compiled, that is a compiler. So with the help of the compiler, the high level language is going to compile and it is converting into assembly language. So after that assembly, it is going to done assemble. So whatever the assemble, that converted into assemble, that object file is going to be link. So after linking, you will get the executable file. So that executable file is going to be load in the chip. So let's take this was a chip. Okay, so this is actually the process. So the high level language, whatever the language, that is a software program we want to store in the chip, that software is going to be compiled. After that is assembled. After that it is going to be linked. That is a .exe file, executable file. That executable file is going to load on the chip. Okay, so once it loads on the chip, then the chip is going to perform the operation. So a compilation is nothing but it is a translation plus optimization. Compilation is nothing but is a combination of translation, translating one language into another language, translation plus it is doing the operation like optimization. Okay, and compiler determines the quality of code. Okay, it determines quality of code in the form of like uses of CPU resources, memory access scheduling and the code size. So it uses use of CPU resources. So the quality can be measured in the determined in the by using the CPU resources and memory access scheduling based on memory access scheduling and also based on the code size. The quality of a code can be determined by using these parameters. So this is a general description of the compilation. So the compilation is nothing but it's a combination of translation plus optimization. Let me explain you the structure of compiler. So compiler is having two parts, like front end and back end. Front end and back end. So compiler is having a front end and back end. So what this front end consists of and what is a back end? So front end is going to check whether the program is correctly written in terms of programming language syntax and semantics. So let me write that point. The front end going to check. It checks whether program is correctly written in terms of programming language syntax and semantics. So that explains the front end. So the front end is only concentration of whether the program is correctly written in that language. It is a high level language, the syntax and semantics. Then what about the back end? So back end is responsible. It is a main responsible. The back end is responsible for translating the source into assembly code. Translating the source code into assembly code. So the compiler, the main operation, it is a software program which is used to convert one language into another language. So here the compiler, the front end, is going to check whether the program is written in terms of programming language, that is a high level language syntax, by using syntaxes and semantics. So that you are going to see, that you are able to see whatever the code you are writing, that you are able to see that it is a front end. And the back end is nothing but the compiler responsibility of translating the source code into assembly code. So the front end is nothing but the lexical analysis, syntax analysis, and semantic analysis. So in the front end, we are going to observe lexical analysis, syntax analysis, and semantic analysis. So then what about the back end? So the back end is going to analyzes whatever the code that we have written, so to translate from source to the assemble, and it is going to optimization and code generation. So this is a structure of compiler. A compiler consists of front end and the back end. So the front end is going to check whether the program is correctly written in the programming language, like using lexical analysis, syntax analysis, and semantic analysis. Whereas the back end is responsible for translating the source code into assembled code by analyzing, optimizing, and by using the code generation technique. It is going to be translate the source code into assembly code. Thank you.